Okay, this week's unusual instrument is this thing, which is an all-original circa 1910 Fairbanks Vega Whyte Laydie number 2 banjeaurine. Other than the shorter 19¾-inch scale length on the banjeaurine, this banjo is virtually identical to the number 2 regular banjo of the time period. Of course, with a shorter neck, it's tuned higher. In this case, it's C, F, C, E, G, which is what? G, A, B, C, a fourth higher than regular classic banjo tuning. The Whyte Laydie had a number of build characteristics. And of course, it has the blonde maple neck, and it has this, which is a metal band that holds the shoes, and this metal band is countersunk into the rim. And the advantage of that is, with this metal band being countersunk into the rim, you don't have to drill holes in the rim to hold the shoes, which is supposed to, you know, improve the sustain and the tone of the instrument. The tone ring used in the Whyte Laydie was a earlier design of Fairbanks called the electric tone ring. And it's basically a metal hoop, and that hoop sits on top of a metal band that has a scalloped profile along its upper edge. Anyway, it's a tone ring that's much loved by classic fingerstyle banjo players and clawhammer banjo players as well. The dial stick reads Fairbanks banjo made by the Vega company. So Vega made this banjo. They had purchased Fairbanks, you know, some years earlier, but they continued to use the Fairbanks name, and eventually, you know, for several years, eventually they dropped it and just went with Vega. This instrument has the classic engraved griffin inlay on the headstock. The griffin, of course, is a mythological creature which had the head and wings and claws of an eagle and the body of a lion. And the likeness of griffins, gosh, it dates back thousands of years to ancient stone carvings and old coins and such. But it's still a popular subject even, you know, with artists today. And a lot of the Vega and Fairbanks banjos from have, you know, griffin headstock inlays. This banjo has a grooved tension hoop. There's a tension hoop. There's a groove in the top of the tension hoop here that holds the hooks. And later ones, a little bit later ones, had a slightly heavier tension hoop that had notches in the hoop for each of the hooks. Anyway, I'll play it fingerstyle and clawhammer style to give you an idea of what it sounds like.